Now, this week we're looking at designer technologies. Now, this is separate to digital technologies, and it encompasses a much broader range of what we refer to as technology. Now, to start with, I provided you with some timelines. The first, looking at educational technologies, because as teachers, you should be interested and familiar with some of these technologies. But it is important to look at the scope of how technology has developed. It goes back to the invention of language, which was a technology, or is a technology, through to the invention of books and written work, the invention of schools as a system. These are all technologies. And designer technology explores these, and it starts with an exploration of technology and society. How technology is a fundamental important aspect of society, and has always been so. Now, with an exploration of technology and society, we look at the four aspects of designer technology. The first of these are what we frame as engineering technologies, so engineering principles and systems, and materials and technology specializations. So students learn how to construct things, how to glue things together, how to build things out of blocks, how to make objects, how to saw objects, how to sew them. All of these physical activities involved in the construction and design and building of materials. But they learn about the different materials, how wood is different to plastic, which is different to metal, all the different aspects of the properties of these materials, how sometimes it makes it more difficult to join them together or to take them apart. All of these elements become an important aspect of students learning about technology. Then there's also aspects of food and fibre production and food specialisations that we'll be exploring next week. So within the context of technologies, students develop three different types of solutions. They create a product. It might be a box. It might be a shelter that people can use if they're homeless. It might be a parachute to land an egg safely from a tall building. These are product solutions where something is produced that's tangible and physical and so forth. Students can also, though, develop solutions that are services, which are processes involved with solving a problem that may involve catering, for example, making food for 200 people, or managing a recycling system. So they are services related to technology, but not involving the production of a product. And finally, the third type of solution are environments, where students create a particular environment that solves a problem. So it may be a nice, warm, safe habitation, a building. It may be a garden that enables them to grow food and so forth. So there are environmental solutions that students can create to solve problems as well. Now, these develop over time as students progress in their capabilities. To start off with, students look and learn about their familiar products and services environments, what they're used to at home. Might be looking at their air conditioner and how it works, or their TV remote, and how they can turn on channels and turn off channels and change channels and so forth. So simple things that students are well and truly familiar with. Then they go through a process of learning how to design products and services and environments, so coming up with their own solutions. Now, many of these will be wildly impractical and very imaginative, creating a rocket ship to fly to Brisbane, things of that nature. And that doesn't matter, as long as they're going through the design process of creating solutions to problems. And increasingly, we introduce the concepts around sustainability, so how they should try to reduce waste and make things more efficient and effective and so forth, and their impact upon society, upon the environment, without their safety hazards. These are things that can slowly be introduced to students in years 3 and 4. Then in years 5 and 6, we start looking not necessarily at their own needs, but how we can develop needs for the community. So how our solutions can help the entire community benefit. So it may be the entire community of the school, or their local community, or their state or country. So this broadens their understanding of the types of solutions that they can create, be they products, services, or environments. Now, to do this, students learn how to create solutions using the processes and production skills, investigating and defining, generating and designing new ideas, producing and implementing their solutions, evaluating and testing the effectiveness of those solutions, and collaborating and managing on the process of the design and production of their solutions. So again, students learn how to develop those in stages, and they increasingly become more competent in doing that, and the assessable outcomes describe what is required of the students at each of those levels. Now let's talk about technologies and society in particular. So this is a range of concepts that you need to teach your students so they understand the importance of technology in society and how society and technology are very much interlinked. So they can explore how First Nations communities had different types of technologies than what we currently have today in modern Western societies. They could explore how different services are operated, such as flying doctors and providing medical services to remote communities where they don't necessarily have hospitals and ambulances and other things that we're more familiar with in larger towns and cities. So there are lots and lots of activities students can go through around designing solutions, creating various solutions to problems, and having a lot of fun in that process. So look at the examples that are provided and start thinking about which ones you would be interested in using to address your students' understanding of how products, services, and environments can be used and developed for either their own problems or for their community's needs. And increasingly, as they develop these concepts, introducing the idea of sustainability. Okay, so have a look at the examples and look at your activity where you explore what you would do with your students to teach them through a design project, but focusing on the concept of sustainability, but also thinking about how you would differentiate the needs of different students in your class to meet their own particular interests and needs.